Welcome back to Rugged Made. I'm Jared.
I'm Nick.
We're here in the woodlot, and we're kicking off 2024 with another episode covering our souped-up 300 series splitter. This is episode 3, so if you haven't seen the other videos, be sure to check those out. And if you aren't familiar with what we're doing here, this is just a fun project we've been working on where we wanted to see if we could soup up a regular 300 series to make it cycle faster. So the main thing we did was we took, instead of a 10 horsepower engine with the 16 gallon per minute pump, which is the standard spec on our RS322, we took the 420cc Raven engine, which is approximately 15 horsepower, and we wanted to see if it would turn not only the 22 gallon per minute pump that's standard on our 700 series splitters, but the 28 gallon per minute pump, which normally would require a bigger V-twin, you know, 16 to 20 horsepower engine. So far, if you check out those other videos, we've had great success with this. That extra displacement from, say, a Honda GX390 to a 420 seems to be just enough. We've had no problems with the pump, so we're still in that testing mode, but so far it looks great. And that gained us a lot of speed. If you look at the last video we made in episode 2, what were we seeing? 6+?
Round 6.
Yeah, unloaded, you know, best case scenario, out and back, 6+ second cycle time, which is fast for a hydraulic splitter, and you still have the 22 tons of power. Well, we wanted to see, all right, what's the next thing we could do? And for that, we wanted to play with the cylinder. So here we've got a stock cylinder, which is a 4-inch ID cylinder for the 322, and the rod on this cylinder is 2¼ inches. And that's still fairly large by normal log splitter standards, but you know, it wasn't meant to be an oversized rod. Well, this is a cylinder that I had specially made up for this project. It's still a 4-inch ID, but it's a, let's see, why don't you do the honors here, Nick?
So the cylinder is 4-inch ID, and the rod is 3 inches.
So that's a 3-inch OD rod, so 3/4 of an inch larger than the standard. And what that's gonna do is, on the extend portion of the stroke, it's really not gonna do anything as far as speed's concerned. But on the retract, the pump has to push a lot less volume of fluid into the retract end, the rod end of the cylinder, in order to get it to go back. And with this style of splitter, it's not doing any work, so it's just how fast can it get back and open up this space so we can get the next log in position. So today, we're gonna see how big a difference does that large diameter rod make to our cycle times. What do you think we might see? Any guesses?
I hope for a second improvement.
Okay, so we saw 6+ before. If we can get down close to that 5-second range, that would be pretty awesome, and it'd be fun because, you know, if you're souping up a machine, whether it's a car or a tractor or a log splitter, you know, the whole point is you shouldn't have to ask why. We're doing this just to see how fast can we make it go. But if you are someone who is worried about productivity and, you know, split a lot of firewood quickly, then this may actually make a difference to you. So let's get it fired up and see what we get. So splitting with a four-way, you know, these are not really tough to split logs, but we're consistently seeing 5 seconds, 5.1 out and back cycle times.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
I mean, that was our goal, was to see if we could get down to about 5 seconds. I mean, there's a point of diminishing returns trying to get it to go even faster. You still have to position the next log anyway, but yeah, I found that using the return detent, especially the rod and the push plate were out of the way as soon as I could have possibly wanted them to be out of the way to get either a new log in place or a resplit. Yeah, so now we're just gonna do sort of the more scientific laboratory test where we're not gonna split a log, just best case, out and back cycle time. We've given the fluid some time to warm up, which is gonna have an impact on cycle time, and it's more realistic if you're splitting for hours, your fluid's gonna be hot. And that'll pretty much wrap up the video, is just seeing how fast it can really go unloaded. And then we'll split a little bit more. So let's get our best case, not splitting a log cycle times. So what did you think?
It's fast.
One of the things I really liked about this kind of speed, and by the way, we were consistently seeing 5.1 seconds out and back without splitting, or pretty much the same time when splitting this fairly easy to split straight grain stuff. So that's just a real world 5 seconds out and back. One of the things I liked is if I was trying to get down to these kind of smaller, what we'd call like bundle pieces, man, I could just do split, split, split. And I could get the push plate out of the way as fast as I really wanted to. And one thing that we hear from so many customers or people inquiring about one of our splitters is they want to make smaller pieces because they're selling bundle wood, or they're running like a small wood burning stove that only takes 16 to 18 inch pieces. And so it's not always about, can I split a massive round into four giant pieces? Where I don't really care if it takes 5 seconds or 15 seconds for one stroke, because then I'm going to put those huge pieces into a big furnace, a big outdoor boiler. So I think this really gets into sort of the limits of real world speed. And we ran it with the four-way. You ran it with the four-way, and you still have all that power for splitting. Definitely, we didn't really break down the cycle time separating the extend from the retract. So that'd be something we could look at in a future video. One other thing that we forgot to mention when we talked about the change from the episode 2 to this episode, obviously the big change is this special cylinder with the big rod. We did also throw a larger tank on. Nick did that.
Yeah, we threw a 12-gallon tank on this just for a little extra fluid.
Yeah, we started out with the 8-gallon tank, which is standard on the 300 series, which is fine for the smaller pump that comes standard, but even the 12-gallon tank is really just a stopgap for, it's really not enough fluid for a 28-gallon per minute pump running it, all day in the summer. So that's something we'll be playing with later, but we just figured we'd throw something bigger on it and not to let the fluid get too hot. But there's other stuff we can do. We have some ideas. We'd love to hear your thoughts, so please leave some comments down in the bottom about what you'd like to see us do with this. How far do you want us to take it? We've had comments about, 45s on the fittings. We're going to be doing that. We could get a little more creative if you really want us to do it. And we'll let you know what we think about this as far as, is this something that we should offer for sale? Or should we maybe offer an upgrade kit? So let us know what you think. Thanks a lot for watching, and we'll see you next time.